Good morning, sisters. The intentions for Holy Mass today are for the intentions of Carmel and for the Redemptorists, for our families, friends, and benefactors, and all those recommended to our prayers, especially the complete healing and recovery of Keith. For the deceased members of our families, those who died recently, and the souls in purgatory, and for peace in the world. And it's the feast of St. Clement Hofbauer, our second founder. So we have the special readings and prayers of the feast. I am not ashamed of the gospel, for in it the righteousness of God is revealed through faith, for faith, as it is written, the just one who is righteous will live by faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. To prepare ourselves to celebrate this Holy Mass, we ask the Lord to give us a humble and pure heart. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my sisters, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O gracious God, out of concern for your people, you blessed St. Clement Mary Hofbauer with outstanding zeal for the salvation of souls, and through him proclaimed the kingdom of your grace. Grant that through his intercession we may persevere in faith and follow the path marked out for us by the example of his life. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I planted, Apollo watered, but God gave the growth. So neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who gives the growth. The one who plants and the one who waters have a common purpose, and each will receive wages according to the labor of each. For we are God's servants, working together. You are God's field, God's building. According to the grace of God given to me, like a skilled master builder, I laid a foundation, and someone else is building on it. Each builder must choose with care how to build on it. For no one can lay any foundation other than the one that has been laid. That foundation is Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Praise the Lord, all you nations. Extol him, all you peoples. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. For great is his steadfast love towards us, and the faithfulness of the Lord endures forever. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory. Speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
From among the disciples, the Lord appointed 70 and sent them on ahead of him in pairs to every town and place where he himself intended to go. He said to them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Go on your way. See, I am sending you out like lambs into the midst of wolves. Carry no purse, no bag, no sandals, and greet no one on the road. Whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this house.' And if anyone is there who shares in peace, your peace will rest on that person, but if not, it will return to you. Remain in the same house, eating and drinking whatever they provide, for the laborer deserves to be paid. Do not move about from house to house. Whenever you enter a town and its people welcome you, eat what is set before you, cure the sick who are there, and say to them, 'The kingdom of God has come near to you.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Anyone encountering the story of St. Clement and learning about his life will be immensely impressed by the amount of activity he did in favor of the gospel. He spent his life establishing the Communities of Redemptorists, in a fairly new organization in the church then, and in the 18th century, and was a tireless, indefatigable worker in the vineyard of the Lord. And he founded about 24 different communities all over Europe, traveled all over Europe, and was subject to all kinds of persecutions because he was living through the time of the French Revolution, all kinds of revolutions, upheavals in society, and all the rest of it. But the secret of his life was not in the public works. The secret of his life, of course, was interior. His interior life is what draws us, Redemptorists anyway, to a great affection for Clement. I would only highlight three little incidents or three aspects of his life which give meaning to all the activity. The first was when he was 7 years of age. He had a sort of religious experience, thanks to his mother. He was 7 years old in the year 1758 when his father died. And his mother took this little boy into the room where his father lay on the bed, and over that bed there was a crucifix. And she said to him, "Your father is dead, but now this is your father, Jesus. He will look after you." And somehow it had an impression on the child. And whether it was his mother or somebody formulated this in a phrase that stuck in his life. Nur Mut, only courage. Gott lenkt alles, God directs everything. So that summed up a very early experience in his life, which never left him. The second thing that is surprising about Clement, because of his intense activity, is that he spent 8 years as a hermit before he discovered the Redemptorists. He was a hermit in his native Austria, in a place called Mühlfrauen, and he was a hermit in Italy. Incidentally, he was an extraordinarily energetic walker. He walked from Vienna to Rome several times, I mean 4 or 5 times in his life, and used to bring friends with him on the walk. And that was an enormously long walk. But he was a hermit the second time in Trivoli outside Rome. So this experience of the hermit life stayed with him and informed his own inner life during all the activity, not just the walks, but his work as a Redemptorist. And he used to say about the hermitage in Tivoli, there one could really pray. It was one of his holy places. And the third thing is that in the midst of the activity, when eventually he did become a Redemptorist, he was already in his mid-30s, he became what we call nowadays a missionary prophet, because he took this charism of Alphonsus, who was still alive when Clement joined, he took this charism and translated it into German. I don't mean just literally translated the language, but translated the charism. In other words, he was able to carry this sense of abundant redemption and give it a shape and form appropriate to where he was living. But he was always a hermit at heart. And indeed, that is how people account for his activity, that he was able in the midst of it to go into his own hermitage of the heart at any moment. So in the midst of very demanding and difficult and even of persecutions and even being imprisoned at one stage, the hermitage of the heart saw him through all these ups and downs. And so we are immensely proud of Saint Clement, and we revere him, particularly in Northern Europe, because in Southern Europe, the congregation was dominated by Saint Alphonsus, Doctor of the Church. But in Northern Europe, Clement brought the congregation, we say, across the Alps. And so it was from there that it spread all over Europe, Northern Europe, and to the New World, as it was called then, to America and Canada, and subsequently to all the countries, well, not all the countries in the world, but to 80 countries in the world today. He did say one time that the best means for becoming holy is to sink oneself into the divine will, like a stone into the sea, and let oneself be rolled and tossed about at will in the care of God. So we pray today for the Redemptorists around the world, that they may be faithful to this vocation and to the way in which Clement interpreted it for us. Saint Clement Mary Hofbauer, pray for us. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Cleanse me from my sin. So let us pray together that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
God our Father, accept our lives along with these gifts. And through the mystery which we celebrate, strengthen us as you strengthen St. Clement. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. You are glorified in your saints, for their glory is the crowning of your gifts. In the life of St. Clement, you give us an example. In our communion with him, you give us his friendship. In his prayer for the church, you give us strength and protection. His witness spurs us on to victory, to share the prize of everlasting glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. With the angels and archangels and the whole company of saints, we sing our unending hymn of praise.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the offering of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Clement and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Stephen, our Bishop, Sylvester, his auxiliary, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I
am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
I thank my God, confident that the one who began a good work among you will bring it to completion by the day of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. O God, you have nourished us in this Eucharistic banquet, which in marvelous ways unites the faithful of all times. Grant, we pray, that we may receive strength from this heavenly bread, so that we may be enabled to attain to everlasting banquet in the company of your saints, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.